set time to be holy. Speak off with thy Lord. Abide in him always, and feed on his word. Make friends of God's children. Help those who are weak, forgetting in nothing his blessing to see. Take time to be holy. The world rushes on. Spend much time in secret with Jesus alone. By looking to Jesus, like him thou shalt be. Thy friends in thy conduct his likeness shall see. Take time to be holy. Let him be thy guide, and run not before him, whatever betide, in joy or in sorrow. Still follow thy Lord, and looking to Jesus, still trust in his word. Take time to be holy. Be calm in thy soul. Each thought and each temper beneath his control. Thus, led by his Spirit, the fountains of love, thou shalt soon be fitted for service above.
Come to Jesus, he'll wash you and forgive you. And then you know you live your life for him. You are here now, God brought you to Horemo. God will teach you his work of true holiness. He will give you the knowledge of his word. Your life will change, you will be fruitful and happy. Into Jesus, he washed me and forgave me. And now I know I live my life for him. You come to Jesus.
Come to Jesus.
He washed you and forgave you. And then you know
you live your life for him.
We're going to take it again. Make sure you follow me directly. Some years ago, I gave my life to Jesus. Jesus took me and washed my sins away. And then he gave me the power to live for him. My life has changed. Now I am happy, happy. Came to Jesus, he washed me and forgave me. And now I know I live my life for him. You come to Jesus,
come to Jesus,
he'll wash you and forgive you. And then you know you live your life for me. Sin is killing, my friend. Do you know that? I came to tell you because I love you. Come to Jesus, or else you will perish. Time is flying, or you may be too late, too late. Come to Jesus, he washed me and forgave me. And now I know
I live my life for him.
You come to Jesus.
Come to Jesus.
He'll wash you and forgive you. And then you know
you live your life for him.
Some years ago, God brought me to Horemo. Jesus took me and taught me true
holiness.
And then he gave me the knowledge of his word. My ministry changed. Now I am fruitful and happy. Came to Jesus, he washed me and forgave me. And now I know I live my life. Jesus.
Come to Jesus.
He'll wash you and forgive you. And then you know you live your life for Him. You are here now. God brought you to Oremo. God will teach you His word of true holiness. And He will give you the knowledge of His word. Your life will change. You will be fruitful. I came to Jesus. He washed me and forgave me. And now I know I live my life for Him. Everybody come to Jesus.
Come to Jesus.
He'll wash you and forgive you. And then you know
you live your life for Him.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Now let's take this as a simple song. Amen.
Amen.
It's a simple prayer song. You are asking God to teach you His word. Amen.
Amen.
Lord, teach me Your word. Lord, teach me Your word. I want to know Your word. Lord, teach me Your word. Lord, teach me Your word. Lord, teach me Your word. Oh, Lord, teach me.
Lord, teach me Your word.
I want to know Your word.
Lord, teach me Your word.
Amen.
I want.
Everybody sing.
Lord,
open your mouth and sing. Pray to God.
Lord, teach me Your word.
Amen.
I want to know Your word. Lord, teach me Your word. Lord, teach me Your word. Lord, teach me Your word.
Everybody sing.
Lord, teach me Your way.
Amen. your will. Lord, teach me your will.
I want to know your will.
Lord, teach me your will.
I want to do your will.
Lord, teach me your will.
My God. I want to follow it.
Lord, teach me your will.
I want to do your will.
Lord, teach me your will.
My God.
I want to know your will.
Lord, teach me your will. Lord, teach me your will.
I want to know your will.
Father, teach me.
I want to do your will.
Lord, teach me your will.
My God.
I want to know
your hand.
Lord, teach
glory
me
to God.
Will.
Amen.
Lord, teach me your will.
I want
Lord,
to know
teach me your will.
Lord, teach me to pray. Lord, teach me to pray. I want to pray to you.
I want to pray to you. Lord, teach me to pray. God, teach me to pray. God, teach me to pray.
I want to pray to you.
Lord, teach me to pray.
My God, teach me.
Father, teach me.
Lord, teach me.
I love to follow it.
Love.
These songs at all?
Yes,
only few are recording. Oh, you are recording?
Yes, sir.
Uh-huh. Pass it to one another.
Okay.
Revival in Canada. Okay, let's go before the Lord in prayer. Commit yourself to Him. You have sung it already. Run through it before the Lord. Teach me your word. Teach me your way. Teach me your will. Teach me to pray. Teach me to sing. Teach me to love. Teach me to preach. the character of a true Christian. In Ephesians chapter 4. Ephesians chapter 4. I read from verse 1. I, therefore, the prisoner of the Lord. Hallelujah. The character of a true Christian. Ephesians chapter 4, verse 1. I think the best way the receiver would have been brought closer here, because these words are recorded. For them to go off and come up, go off, is going to affect the recording. Because the shells is too far from the receiver. That's season. Let's wait, because it's not. Is that okay? Yeah. Ephesians Amen. Ephesians chapter 4 from verse 1. I therefore, the prisoner of the Lord, beseech you that ye walk worthy of the vocation wherewith ye are called. I am pleading with you as one suffering because of the gospel, as one even now in prison because of my labor over you, because of my going round among you to preach the gospel of Christ. I am begging you that as Christians called to a way of life, you should walk worthy. You should walk worthy of the vocation wherewith you are called. You are called as a Christian, and Christianity has a standard of living already prescribed way of life, already defined way of life. Please follow it, the defined way, prescribed way. Walk worthy of your calling. Walk worthy of your calling. As the driver that drives on the way with his eyes straight before him, seeing the way before him, not being careless, I am begging you, requesting of you, don't be careless in your Christian life. Don't be careless in your Christian living. You are called as a man, a Christian man. Walk in that way. You are a Christian man. You are a Christian woman. Walk in that way. Christian woman. You are a Christian youth. A Christian youth, walk in that way. As a Christian youth should. Children that are Christian children that have come to understand the gospel of Jesus, walk commensurate to your calling, according to this pattern already spelled down, laid down for us in the gospel. You are a Christian minister, a Christian worker. Show it that way in your Christian life. Let people know this is a Christian minister, a Christian worker. With all lowliness and meekness, with all 100% of lowliness, humility, all stretch humility to the fullness of it. Take yourself to the extreme of humility. Be humble to the extreme. All lowliness and meekness, gentleness. Be gentle to the extreme. Be harmless to the extreme. In the family, in the church, in the workplace, in the school, in the society, let your humility be great. Let your meekness be great. God said Moses was the meekest of all men in the world in his time. Humility, gentleness. Moses was the meekest of all men alive in his day, a Christian leader. With all lowliness and meekness, with long suffering, long-suffering, patience. The person sleeping there should go and stand outside. Yes, go out there, stand behind, because you are weak. Go to the back. My sister there. Go to the back. You are sleeping. With long suffering, be patient so long. Be recognized for your patience. Let people recognize your patience. Let even the offenders, those that offend you, agree that you are patient. Long patience, long suffering. Forbearing one another in love. Forbearing. Somebody has done something bad, but bear it. In love. Bear it. That's family life. That's the Christian life. Bear what that person has done against you, or is even doing against you. And do it in love. So you can see the life of a true Christian, the character of a true Christian, very patient, humble. What about these ones that are pushed for? You've got contaminated by the world. That is not the life of Christ. That you come and push people down. Talk anyhow. Say, come, I must have my way. That is not Christianity. It is not. Okay, these people are giving me problems. I will deal with, I know how to handle them. I'm going to be rough before them. They will fear me. That's not Christianity. You have not come to it yet. Which way did Jesus threaten the people that handled him roughly? Which way? So, this is the character of a true believer. Endeavoring to keep the unity of the Spirit in the bond of peace. Make effort. Work hard to keep the place calm. Make effort. You could complain. The thing is so hard that you could shout. You could cry out. Now everybody must know what I'm passing through here. Now, make effort to keep that environment quiet. To keep the environment in peace. Pay for the peace of that environment. Pay for the peace of that environment. Pay for the peace of the family. If you can bear it, if you can keep quiet, there will be peace. Pay for it. Pay for the peace of the church. If you take action, things will scatter. But what if you do not take action? There will be peace. Pay for the peace of that church. Be quiet. Bear it. This is Christian character. Christian character. Yes. In verse 17. This I say therefore, and testify in the Lord, that ye henceforth walk not as other Gentiles walk in the vanity of their mind. Henceforth, from now forward, from the time you have come to Christ forward to the end of your life, don't live like sinners do. The way sinners do it, you came from there, don't live like that. Don't. They live in pride, in the vanity of their mind. They live in pride, and pride is emptiness. They feel high. They feel superior. Don't feel superior. Don't feel superior. Whatever is your rank in the society, superiority is what they do and demonstrate among the sinners. Henceforth, from today, never see yourself higher than any other woman. Never see yourself higher than any other man. Whatever is your privilege in life. Whatever. The sinners do that thing for pride. Show their pride. You have no pride to show. Your pride has been crucified with Christ. Don't be proud anymore. These sinners, they walk in the vanity of their mind, having their understanding darkened, being alienated from the life of God through the ignorance that is in them because of the blindness of their heart. Can you see the multiple sickness of sinners? See their sicknesses in multiple, while the understanding is darkened. They can't understand. They can't understand the ways of God. They can't understand the word of God. They cannot understand the reason why somebody should kick you and you run about. What do you mean? That's the problem you're having with your relation over the oppression you're receiving. Why? Now go and show them. If you don't know how to do it, just watch me. Tell him, don't go for me. Your understanding is darkened. Sinner, and they are alienated from the life of God. They are far away from the life of God. They are not near where God is. That is why they are behaving like that. They cannot reflect the light of God. They are too far away from God. Again, it says, there's ignorance in them. Ignorance. They don't know. I don't know that God. I don't know the Bible. Whose Bible? I don't know it. I don't read it. Ignorance is in them. And as a result, they are blind. The things they do bring hurt to them. They don't see the way. They push things down anyhow, because they are not seeing. Don't walk like these people from henceforth. Don't behave like that. Don't bring that type of mind to the church. You were among them over there. Now you claim you have known Jesus. Why are you bringing that type of mind to the church? Wow! In that time, when you were in the world, you may not speak, in fact, husband and wife, you may not speak for 3 months. You are in the same house. 3 months. You may not talk. Husband and wife do not trust themselves. Something has angered them. No relationship anymore. Hey, and you come to Christ with that? No. If truly it is Christ, if truly you have come to holiness revival movement that Christ has established in this end time to be a light of the Gentiles, never do that type of thing anymore. Don't. You'll be scattering. You'll be doing harm. Yes. And concerning these sinners, who being past feeling have given themselves over unto lasciviousness to walk all uncleanness with greediness. Another compound type of problem of sinners. Past feeling, which means they don't feel anymore. Having their conscience seared with a hot iron, they don't feel anymore. They can kick a person, not the person will cry. They are laughing. They don't feel. They have gone beyond feeling. They're not sympathetic. No human feeling. And because of that, they have given themselves over to everything their body wants, lasciviousness, any lust, any desire that crosses their heart, they pursue it. Whichever person from the heart, that's not their business. All they want is, I want to have it. That's for sinners. Gentiles. But you, say you have come to Jesus, I beg you, don't confuse this Christianity. Don't confuse this Christianity in the fellowship, in the church, in the chapter meeting, in the family. Don't, wives, don't bring this character to your husband. Don't confuse Christianity before your children. Husbands, don't bring this character before your wife, confusing everybody about Christianity. And yet you are the leader. Leader of what? You are confusing people. That's what the word says. Don't do that. They walk all uncleanness with greediness. All uncleanness. Anything that is unclean, that's not their business. It's unclean to you. All the dresses, see the dresses, unclean dresses. But it doesn't matter anything to them. Because they don't have feeling anymore. Their conscience is not alive. Greediness. Everything must be their own. They have not had enough. Those who are doing recording, record the preacher and record the audience. So that in case somebody is tired of seeing the preacher or wants to know how the audience is responding to the preacher, you give him chance to see it too. Amen? Praise. That makes watching the things sweet. Is that not so?
Yes.
So, that's the word of God. But you have not so learned Christ. Christianity is different from the life of sinners in the world. You never heard that Christ was rude in the society, was stubborn in the family. You never learned that from Jesus. If then you say you're of Christ, you must bring forth the new life. You have not so learned Christ. If so be that ye have heard him and have been taught by him as the truth is in Jesus. You have been taught, you have heard him, now you're hearing him, now he's teaching you. The truth about life is in Jesus, which means all this boastfulness of life, roughness of life, whatever the people claim they gain by it is never the true life. The true life is a life of humility. The true life is a life of meekness, patience. That's the true life. All this, the devil walking like a lion, threatening people, you are a lion. Or a lioness, in case you are a woman. Yes, that ye put off concerning the former conversation, the old man, which is corrupt according to the deceitful lusts. Put off, remove that cloth. When the prodigal son came home, what happened to the cloth he was wearing? It was changed. It was removed. You have come back to the place of life. You have come back to your father's control. And the glory of your father must be seen in you. And your father is a big man in the society. People come into that house, let them not see rats on your body. Let them not see rats on your body. You came from a far country where you didn't have clothes. You were nowhere covered there. You didn't have. But now you have come to life. For this my son was lost, he is found. He was dead, he's alive. You have come to life. You are now found. The dignity of sonship must come back. That prodigal son must have resembled his father. And you want to see the glory of your father on you. You came with anger. Your anger was tearing you down there. Anger. You want to bring anger to the father's house. Please, don't do that. Put off that wrath. You came with pride. You came with pride. Put off that old man. Pride. Put it off from you. You came with him. To cry. No, that's an old man. Put off that old man. You came with life. No, that's an old man. Put off that old man from you. Because that old man is corrupt according to the deceitful desires, feelings, and interests of sinners. Sinful loss. He told you, yes, he raised shoulders, everybody will bow. So you were raising shoulders up and down. It's a lie. How everybody fears me because of my anger, because, and therefore, every religion is already going to do. It's a lie. You have been deceived to spoil yourself. You have been deceived to mar your beauty. You have been deceived to look a fool. For anger rested in the bosom of fools. Put them off. And be renewed in the spirit of your mind. Everybody say, and be renewed in the spirit of your mind. Say it. Say it again. Say it again. The Lord is advising you to change your thoughts. Your thoughts make you what you are. Because of how you thought, you were not at peace with many people. You were suspecting everybody. The Lord said, change that spirit. Change that mind. Change it. The devil was the one putting those thoughts into your heart. The devil was the one. All those things you are thinking, making you feel, oh, my interest here, I like this, I like. Change it. Change it. Thoughts. Ah, yes, I think everybody's seeing me, I'm feeling fine. I'm dressed properly now. I don't know, how do you see? Yes, yes. Change it. Amen. Dress the best way. It does not show that you are in the spiritual best condition. So that's what we're looking for, is not how best you dress, but how righteous you are.
Amen.
So change those thoughts. The type of husband I will marry, that is the type. Change that thought. It's God that will give you a husband.
Amen.
Did you bring yourself to this world?
No.
Why are you putting your thoughts so high? To the extent the voice of the Holy Spirit cannot be heard anymore. Change those thoughts. And be renewed in the spirit of your mind. You were focusing long time on a kind of business. Even before you came to Christ. And you have come to Christ. And your mind is in that business. Have you considered, have you thought over it again? What can this do for Jesus? What can it do? If I achieve this, then what will it be to the gospel? Have you thought about that? Change those thoughts. Change those thoughts. You were always thinking about your past girlfriend. Your past boyfriend. And it was giving you pleasure. Change it. Everybody tell him to change it.
Change.
Tell her.
Change.
Tell him again. Repeat it to her.
Change.
That is what the word of God is telling you. Be renewed in the spirit of your mind. What did that person do to you that you have, all your interest is always there? You have secretly put a picture somewhere, you go to look at it. Where? Polluting your soul. Wow. What pleasure? Pleasure of iniquity. Change. And be renewed in the spirit of your mind. And that ye put on the new man, which after God is created in righteousness and true holiness. Everybody say, true holiness.
True holiness.
There are those who are in holiness movement. There are those who are in true holiness movement. Their lives are clean. Others are here in name only. But that those who are here in deed, in truth, and in deeds, true holiness. Not the one you proclaim with your mouth. Not the one you show in dressing. No, it goes beyond that. Confession of mouth is good. Yes, your dressing is good, but it goes to the heart. It is not just the one you show in the public, in the secret also. Between you and your God. For he sees. That's why the word of God is saying that ye put on the new man, which after the pattern of God, after the nature of God, is created in righteousness and true holiness. Please be truly holy. Holy revival movement, be truly holy. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Wherefore, putting away lying. Speak every man truth with his neighbor, for we are members one of another. Hi, how could you speak lies in the church? How? You like this came up to tell the church in a testimony. I've been a Christian for long and God has used me in various ways. And it's a lie. But he's speaking confidently. The Lord used me. I have raised about 5 dead people. He's telling lies. I'm telling you, these testimonies we ask people to come and give is opportunity to advertise themselves. So the way you see him, you see her, hey, great Christians are here. You begin, it tells you, in fact, since this year began, I have fasted for 100 days. You calculate. Okay, it means he eats once in a minute. Hey, God, make me like that. Make you like a liar. That is what, when they say our mouth is our own. Who will know? And in the church, very peacefully sitting there, using the tongue to exalt themselves. Don't do that. Don't. Speak truth. Why do you want to deceive your brother in the church? Why do you want to deceive your sister? And they use lies to marry. They use lies to tell many stories, how much possession they have in this place, in that place, how much money they have in the bank. How much is just because you want to marry? You want to confuse a human being? Don't do that in the church. Don't. Tell me I will not do it.
I will not do it.
Say it again.
I will not do it.
That's what God wants of you. Speak lies in them all. Speak truth one with another. Give your brother the correct state. All these stories that the world do, somebody that maybe a sister's mother died, and the information came to you, and please tell sister so-and-so, maybe the person giving you the information may train you how to say it. tell her, her mother is critically in the hospital. And the mother said she wants to see her. You're talking about a dead person. Don't do that type of thing here. You hear? Of course, sometimes you may use wisdom, but never, the wisdom that involves lie is not pure wisdom. The wisdom that involves telling lies is not pure wisdom. It can give deliverance, but you will pay for it. Because that deliverance is for a while. Speak truth. One with another. Be ye angry and sin not. Lay not the sun go down upon your wrath. This one will catch many people on the way to heaven. This demon will stand at the gate and say, no, you cannot come in here. You have broken this one. No. Because you have kept anger with some people for 1 year. You have kept anger against some people for 10 years. In fact, you have shared anger with your family against another family. And it is a shared anger. For all these years, you have nothing to do with that family. Why? Our family doesn't like them. So you join. You were doing that before you came to Christ. Don't do that anymore. Your family members are in darkness. They have not known Jesus. Ignorance is in them. Amen.
Amen.
Be ye angry and sin not. Be careful what you say with your mouth when you are angry. Be careful what action you take when you are angry. Be careful the places you go to when you are angry. Be ye angry? Don't commit sin. Are you writing things down?
Yes.
Be angry, don't commit sin. Let your anger be short-lived.
Amen.
Don't allow your anger to last. Husband and wife, take note of this. You are married to an unbelieving husband, take note of this. You are married to an unbelieving wife. Take note of this. This woman is provoking me. Pray that your provocation should be short-lived. Pray that you will never slap her because she has provoked you. I know the provocation can be terrible. Because when Satan is involved in provoking you, if you are not careful, you will scatter. But don't sin. Don't open your mouth to speak foolishly. Don't call yourself and let it not last. If up to tomorrow the anger is burning, don't wait for hellfire. Just start doing something on yourself immediately. That there is spiritual fall in your life. For bringing the anger. But he didn't apologize to me. He didn't come to apologize. Yes, the sin is still on him actually. But you're free inside. You and him are two different souls. You and him are two different souls. But I don't know how the anger just comes by itself. Go to God who said this. What did you? God, you say our anger should be short-lived. But I am not able to do it. It's just the power of sin is still there somewhere. Let God clear that thing off from you. So that it will mean nothing to you. He stole my money. Nothing. He slapped me. He abused me. Nothing. He poured water on my body. Your heart inside will not even bother about it. Will not feel it. That's what I'm saying. Your heart inside. That is what salvation is, a miracle. Go for that miracle. Plead for that miracle. So that it will not move you. You will not even bother about it. The person will be feeling it. Because he has not come for forgiveness. He will still be feeling it, but you will not feel it. Your supernatural hand has tempered with your heart. When you laminate a paper, can water destroy it?
No.
Exactly. Let it be outside where there is heavy rain. Let other papers lie outside with it. The other unlaminated paper will be damaged by the rain, but the laminated one clean. After the rain, go and bring it back. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Let your heart be laminated by the blood of Jesus. You won't have problem anymore. Be angry. Be ye angry. Come. What is happening to you? Somebody is trying to abuse your body Yeah, I love that. Leave me alone there. I know I'm born again. I can't do it. Wonderful. Is this what I'm saying to somebody that wants to rubbish and send you to hell? Be ye hungry. Was not Jesus angry at the habits of the Pharisees? When there was a sick man there, and they said, today is Sabbath day. Let's see what he will do. He fed, the Bible says he gripped him. He looked at him angrily. Be ye angry. But sin not. Shall live. That is what the Lord is saying. He said, but I don't know how to be angry. Then you're not hating sin. He that loves righteousness hates iniquity. And hatred goes with anger. Hate that thing, you'll be provoked. Otherwise, how will you handle Satan? Scar bomb Satan. That you say, me, I am peaceful with everybody. In fact, I don't know how to be angry as you see me now. Even if you are carrying my money, I see with my face, with my eyes. I may not even do anything. I am just peaceful. Money that would have bought a lot of things and prayed for the gospel of Christ, Satan is carrying it to the beer parlor. I don't bother. Be angry! Only sin not. And let it be shortly. That's the word. Neither give place to the devil when you are angry. Because, be careful. Satan, who sponsors provocation, is standing there with you. And will want, because when you pump a thing, when you have pumped a tire, the vehicle is easy to push. When you have pumped air into a thing, it becomes light. You can maneuver it. So when Satan pumps anger into you, he can easily take over you. The words you will speak, the actions you will take, he can easily take over. That's why the Bible says you could be angry because of what that person did. Don't give the devil a place. Otherwise, he will take over. Don't give him a place. He's there. Do you know that when somebody did a bad thing, or somebody does a bad thing against you, your thoughts begin to run, and many suggestions are coming into your heart. Suggestion number one, number two, number three, number four, number five. I can do this, 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 I can do this. They're just coming. Don't give the devil a place. Jesus there.
Amen.
Let him that stole steal no more. But rather, let him labor, working with his hands, the thing which is good, that he may give to him that needeth. Get the instructions here. You used to steal from your sister. Don't do it again. You were against her as a sinner. Don't do it again. You used to steal from your brother. Don't do it again. Already you have confessed and done your restitution, apologized. Don't do it again. You used to steal from your husband. Don't do it again. Let him that stole steal no more. You used to steal from your wife. Don't do it again. That's instruction number one. Character of a true Christian. Then he said, but rather, labor, working with your hands. Labor, you are looking for job. Good, look for it and pray. God who is teaching us righteousness, knows the place of walk in righteousness. How it will assist you. So pray, but all together, don't steal. Even before the job comes, don't steal. Now it says something also here. Walking with your hands the thing which is good. The work you should do should be good work. Not dirty job, sinful job, tobacco place, brewery. No. Make sure the work you are doing is a good job. So that the money coming from it should be clean money. Amen?
Amen.
The money coming should be clean money. It is time for the cameraman to turn his camera. We're doing two jobs. See, they're not doing their work correctly. Praise the Lord. Amen. Let that job be a good job. Then that you may have to give to him that needeth. It is in working your heart. Then you give to people. Don't tighten your hand. Help people. When the sister yesterday was giving testimony of a sister that helped her pay her flight ticket to Toronto, I said, oh, I hope we should learn how good it is to do good. See how happy the sister was. See how grateful. I said, God, increase my good works.
Amen.
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 I was praying for myself. Amen. I said, God, see what that sister did. Pay the ticket for this, this our beloved sister. Otherwise, how would she have come for the conference? I said, God, increase me more.
Yeah.
May God increase you.
Yeah.
To learn to give to others. And make them happy. Make them praise the Lord for you. Yeah. Let no corrupt communication proceed out of your mouth. But that which is good to the use of edifying, that it may minister grace unto the hearers. This again is a beautiful, we have a beautiful lesson to learn. Because our heart can remember, especially it can remember bad things. Because we are in the world full of bad things. Our heart can remember. Don't put in your brother a bad story. He will remember it and it will trouble him. Faith cometh by hearing. Hearing by the word of God. Faith comes by hearing the word of God. The opposite of faith is what? Fear also comes by hearing. Hearing bad stories. In those days in the village, we were little children. And we were outside in the night telling stories. After they had told us stories of witches and wizards, how they fly like this, they do like this, and then mommy said, hey, Paul, go inside the room. We will not see that in that room. Immediately you enter the room, you run back because they're there. I didn't see it. Are you hearing me? Does it happen so to you? That is it. So why communicating stories that will discourage your brother? Judge very well. Do you know that person has backslidden? This one also has backslidden. This one also has backslidden. What are you trying to tell him? He will backslide too. That's what you want to tell him. Don't do it. Evil communication. Put it far from you. That which a person sees may last in his mind. You saw, maybe you were passing by. Let's even say you saw a man and a woman rubbing themselves in one corner. They say, hey, see, why are you asking him to see? You want to corrupt his mind? Do you know this thing you are asking her to see will last for 50 years in his mind? And any time his mind comes there, it might even be the reason for his stumbling in the next 20 years. So be very careful. What you say, the actions you take, you who saw, God gave you grace. Because you didn't plan to see, you are now getting somebody that will he have the same grace? Will he have the same grace to see this thing and still be the way you are? Be careful, don't corrupt somebody. There is no communication. There is no corrupt communication. It's talking that will corrupt somebody. Conversation that will corrupt somebody. Stories that will corrupt somebody. Maybe about your brother, about this pastor, about this pastor's wife, about this one. Do you know what I've heard about him again? Do you know, my sister, you're on your way to hell.
Okay.
You're damaging the people of God. You're damaging the house of God. Because you're putting things in people. Some of these are young in the faith. They don't even know how to pray out these things. They don't know. And you're corrupting them. You're putting chemicals upon their bones to weaken their bones. Are you for Jesus? Are you for Jesus? Are you really looking for his righteousness? Are you really looking for his holiness? In fact, are you looking for the righteousness of your brother? That you are telling corrupt story. Some parents will tell their children, even if I am dead, I have nothing to do with that house. You hear me? Even if I am dead, as long as I'm alive, that man and his children, don't greet them. Have you seen like that? Is that a good training for those innocent children? Then why are you training your brother in a bad way? Why are you transferring your anger to somebody else? Why are you doing that? To corrupt him. Now, you have changed your sister's thought towards that person. She was free before. She was free before. You have changed your sister's thought. Now look at this. Look at it this way. You were passing by a road and you saw some boys smoking in a building somewhere by the roadside. And you know they were smoking bad thing. So the other day, you were passing by. You don't have anything to say about Jesus. It's about smokers. And you're passing with your brother. And when you came to that place, the computer of your brain rolled up. Hey, this is the place I saw people smoking. In fact, those boys, they're smoking here. Now, with that story, any time your brother comes to that point, he will look that direction. Are they there? I've given him job. I've given him job. Where didn't you talk about Jesus that time? So let's be careful. May God purge iniquity from your life. Hey, Jesus. That you become clean indeed, righteous indeed, holy. He that keepeth his mouth keepeth his life. Let no corrupt communication proceed out of your mouth, But that which is good to the use of edifying, that it may minister grace unto the hearers. There are many good stories that will encourage your brother, encourage your husband, encourage your friend. You know, I know where some of you women are suffering from your husbands because you have been sinful communicators along with him. Anytime he fights outside, he comes and busts like a man. Yes. Do you know me? And you will talk. You say, ah, that's my husband. The man will be happy. He will raise his shoulder. But you are not born again. When he comes and talk, why did you do that? Hey, this woman has spoiled. This woman is not giving me pleasure again. That's where the persecution is coming. Are you hearing me? Because you're not company to sinful conversations anymore. So the pleasure of friendship is dying. So that is it. Don't partake in evil communication. But speak things that will edify, things that will encourage. Things that will provoke someone to good works and to righteous living. And grieve not the Holy Spirit. And grieve not the Holy Spirit of God, whereby ye are sealed unto the day of redemption. Get it this way. You are dressed. Well dressed, beautifully dressed, going for a program. And it was raining. And you came to where water was flowing on the ground. How careful are you to move in that place? Very careful. Because you don't want to soil this cloth. You don't want anything dirty. But what if a car splashed the water on you? It's a great damage. You may, in fact, sometimes you may have to go back home to go and change that law. You are dressed with the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit has sealed you for eternal life. And the character you are exhibiting is paining him, is disturbing him. He will leave you. He will leave you. Because he can't bear those things. How can you be telling lies? Holy Spirit is in your life. How could you act so badly? Holy Spirit is in you. He will live. And once he lives, where do you get eternal life? We don't grieve the Holy Spirit that has sealed you up by God for eternal life. Don't do those things anymore. How much more of saying, hey, the man is disturbing me so much, I just want to go and satisfy him once. Hey! That's your end. Okay. I don't even know whether you will come back to Christ. Because coming back is a work of grace. Why do you think you should have it two times when others have not even got to the first time? Now you think you can just play with grace, play anyhow. Don't deceive yourself. I'm not saying you won't come, you may not be able to come back forever. No, it can happen, but it's rare. But playing with it, we'll be giving precious things to dogs. So change your life. Yes. Lay all bitterness and wrath and anger and clamor and evil speaking be put away from you with all malice. All. Everybody say all.
All.
Say it again. All.
All.
Say it again. All.
All.
Live a life of 100% money free. malice free. Live a life of 100% malice free. He has done this against me. He has 100% free. That's God telling you this. Live all bitterness. You are feeling bitter against someone. Wrath, you will want to spoil things because of anger. Anger, provocations, and clamor, making noise. You know how to shout. My servant, his voice shall not be heard on the street. But when is your voice heard in the house? When you are talking with your wife in the room, especially when you are angry, the neighbors are the ones to suffer it. They say, when two lions are fighting, the grass suffer. Why are you causing the people to suffer? Because you can't have a lower voice. You shout with all your strength. Clamor. Put that far away from you. Put that far away from you. Let it. It was not in your father's house because they didn't know Jesus. Start a family without this thing. Let your children come and learn from you. Amen. Evil speaking evil about people. Do you know that this thing can give pleasure? You just delight in speaking evil about people. You're happy about it. It makes conversation sweet. Yes. Take it also some human character. They come to sell something to you so they can get gain. What are they selling? Somebody's character. You bring the person to you. Do you know? Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I talk and laugh because in my village there used to be a young man there. He was partially dead. We call him Vitus. Whether it's raining, once it is night, just wait that Vitus is coming to your house. And he's coming with the latest story. I'm telling you, if it is night, he was coming with a lamp to your house. And when he comes, Vitus, you're welcome. He starts immediately. Because he's going to another place. So he has to start quickly and deliver your own. Praise the Lord. Do we have Vitus and Vitus sitting down here? That's great news. They do so to receive the love of people. Who told you they cannot love you until you tell them evil of somebody? Who told you that you cannot be loved? Now, if they are rather discovering you as you are coming, they say, here comes an evil speaker. Everybody get ready. Frown your face down. They're frowning face with you because they don't want those things again. The man you told evil to, you do like a butterfly pollination. You bring from here and carry from here and go. So they have known you. Don't do that thing again. Don't live like that again. Don't spoil your name. God wants to make use of your name. God wants to make use of you. Why do you spoil yourself before God? Why? And be kind one to another. Tender hearted. Forgiving one another. Even as God, for Christ's sake, hath forgiven you.
is speaking to a Christian. Now, this thing you have to go and practice it. If you cannot practice it, could they be teaching you? Go and practice it. Where do I get the power to practice it? Where do I get the grace to practice it? It's there in the market, in the supermarket of God. You will go there, you will buy the grace to practice this thing. Go to the supermarket of God. Ask for power not to lie. You will find it there. Go to the supermarket of God. It is the supermarket of grace. Ask for power not to keep malice. They have it there. And they will give you. Buy without money. Go to prayer. You buy with prayer. You get it. And once you swallow that thing, anger has ceased. It's a miracle. Go and bow. Go and bow. Come, buy without money. That's what Jesus is saying. That's what the world is saying. Chapter 5, verse 1. Be ye, back to 32. And be ye kind one to another. Kind in words. Let's speak kindly. Speak lovingly. Speak graciously. Be ye kind. Ruth all bore. Oh, I have found favor in your sight that you speak to your handmaid so kindly. Others would have spoken proudly. Others would have spoken roughly. But you speak, giving me honor, giving me respect, showing me you love me. I can read love in your heart. I can read love in, I see love, I feel free. And satisfied in your presence. Be ye kind one to another, tender hearted, feel for your brother, feel for your sister. If you know how to cry, as he is shedding tears, maybe you also be shedding tears. Oh, is that what happened? If you are not the type that can cry easily, as a shedding tear, don't be laughing. Otherwise, it seems you're not feeling what she's feeling. You're not feeling what he is feeling. I'm feeling pain and you're laughing. Feel with him. Empathize. Where have you led him? Come on, see. Jesus wept. And the people there said, "Behold how he loved him. The heart was tender." What's the reward of tender heartedness? The Lord said, "Tell King Josiah, because your heart was tender and you wept with your heart my word concerning this city, you will die in peace. Amen. I will not cause you to see evil in this land." Be tender hearted. Let's feel for someone. Why are you frustrating him? You're happy? Why are you doing that? So, stop that. Feel with people. Tender hearted. Be ye kind one to another. Show kindness of giving. This life is serious. This life, there are those who have, there are those who have not. Just as you see nature, the people in the tropics have much sunshine, but others don't have. Some nations have much sunshine, some don't have. Some have rain, some don't have. It's like Dubai, I think it may rain twice a year. All year. Once, twice, or what? So they don't use rain to do, I'm farming for rain. No, because there's rain. No, it doesn't rain there. But go to other places every day. That's how life is. So you who have, remember they have not. Give them clothing, shoes, give them. There's an area that we have not touched. Because some of you sitting here now have supermarkets in your houses. If you put the clothes you have and shoes you have to the shop, that it will go beyond the shop, it will be supermarkets. Because you have 1,000 different dresses, which you have kept. Boxes are heaping up. They will testify against you before God. Why are you keeping them? With his other children are crying. With his other children are managing what to put on to go for evangelism. What are you piling those things for? You've never heard that you should be kind hearted. You should think about those who don't have. Give out to people. Why are you covetous? You don't have moderation. Tender hearted, kind, give out money to.
Yes.
Give money. See our sister again. Somebody paid for her ticket, flight ticket. How much? $600. Is that a small money?
No.
But God has given you much more than that.
Amen.
Those who give is not because they have much, they have the heart. Develop that heart. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Forgive one another. Even as God, through Christ, has forgiven you, forgive others also. Even as God, through Christ, has forgiven you, forgive others also. Forgive your wife. All these people who say, divorce, if your wife commits adultery, you should divorce them. Look at this scripture here. Is your wife included in this? In the people you should forgive as God forgave you? Is forgiveness saying that you can, I said, leave my house, but I have forgiven you. Just leave my house. I have forgiven you. What type of confusion is that? The Lord said, just leave him, go to hell. Oh, I have forgiven you, but go to hell. Just I have forgiven you. What confusion could that be? Forgive. Death, what sin? Immorality of your wife? Circumstance pushed her there. Pity her death. Some even use demonic power to hypnotize someone. Why are you not reasoning? Why are you not reasonable? Forgive that. That's what the word is saying. Forgive one another. Forgive your brother. Forgive your wife. She spoke a bad thing. She spoke a bad thing. You know this situation? A man and a wife were quarreling. Before you know it, the wife has picked up something, hit the man here and the two middle teeth, a tooth. Amen?
Amen.
God removed. And the husband is a big man, so no new one will grow. So, you know how bad that is? That the artist will draw such people on the board with their two teeth open to show that there's vacancy somewhere. How they abuse that. But forgive your wife. He did bad. Maybe it's your husband who did it to you. Forgive him. That means the pain will not be there again. The thing is still there, but not the pain. God has taken away the pain. The feeling will not be there in you again towards her. God has taken away that feeling. Jesus was on the cross. And he said, Father, forgive them. For they don't know what they have done. They don't know what they are doing. May God give you this Christian virtue. To demonstrate real Christianity. That people will bless God. People will love Jesus. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
There's much to say. If you continue from verse 5. And let's stop here. Be a Christian. Go and change your relationships with people. Release your face that doesn't smile. Because it's full of bitterness. Go and release that face. When they are in the church singing and clapping for Jesus, you sit in one corner. Look at that clapping as if he's a Christian. Look at that crap. You're busy condemning everybody there. What are the list of people you are condemning? Don't be a trauma. Sharp! Let your light so shine before me that they may see your good works and glorify your Father. Which is in heaven. May the spirit of grace come upon your life.
Amen.
May the Lord pour down the power of change upon your life.
Amen.
May the blood of Jesus come down now like a mighty rain upon us here now and purge everyone, clean everyone, sanctify everyone, perfect everyone for heaven. Rise up upon your feet and begin to worship the Lord. Tell him you are ready for heaven. He should cleanse you. He should cleanse you. He should perfect your life. You don't want to bring shame to him. You don't want to be a child that causes shame to the parent. You don't want to bring shame to Jesus. Go to the supermarket and receive your and buy all those things that are required in your life. Buy them. Supermarket of God. Buy grace. By grace, by the power of God, by purity, by total change of heart, Jesus. Lift up your voice and be praying seriously. Cry unto him. Let a new life take over you. The church, the devil wants to darken the church through you. Don't allow that. Repent! Come
troublemaker anymore. They knew you in the world as a troublemaker. You are now in Christ. Change. Change.
Thank you.
Be alive in Christ. Be alive in Christ. Lay your life low with the fire of righteousness. Lay your heart be sanctified. Ask God for you. You're for heaven, you're not for hell. You've been called to a vocation of life. Leave it. Leave the righteous life. Leave the righteous life. Your brothers are offended at you. Your sisters are offended at you because you are not living. You are not living the lie. Get it now. Get the lie. Get the lie. Get it from Jesus. Receive it. Shine. Make your life shine. Before me. Before men. That's God calling you. Jesus is saying, walk worthy of the profession. He called you to be a Christian. He even said you are a prime minister. Walk worthy.
Go ahead and give him. Go ahead and give him. Go ahead and give him.
Thank him for revealing these things to you. Thank him for giving you the grace. Thank him that your life will not be the same again. Thank you that you're going to show forth the Christian life in perfection. Hallelujah. Begin to thank the Lord. Begin to thank God. Begin to thank the Lord. Worship. 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 Begin to thank the Lord. Your life has changed. Hallelujah. Jesus' name we pray.
What you have just listened to is a production of Holiness Revival Movement Worldwide. Holiness Revival Movement Worldwide is a non-denominational ministry that is given to the propagation of Christ's righteousness and holiness in churches and nations of the world through crusades, revival meetings, production and spread of holiness literature and materials. For other spiritual materials, messages, or inquiries, contact us on 0816-902-3948 or 0805-683-4323. You can also reach us through our email address, holinessrevivalmovement@gmail.com. God bless you.
For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. For God sent not his Son into the world condemn the world, but that the world through him might be saved. Hallelujah.
Jesus, I believe in you. You are my Lord and Savior. I believe
Savior.
Jesus, I believe in you.
I believe.
You are the living Savior. You are the living Savior.
Jesus, I